former NBA forward. He is now an NBA analyst for NBA TV, and he joins me here on the show. Karan, what was your reaction to reading about Kyrie Irving's trade demand?
Man, you know, thanks for having me on the show, Chris. You know, I thought it was, you know, just, you know, one of those things that came out of nowhere. But you obviously can see that, you know, it was something that wasn't right there. You look at the hiring of possibly hiring Chauncey Billups, him going in for the interview and, you know, not wanting to go into that situation, walking on landmines. You know, it's something that's not sitting well, you know, in that organization in Cleveland. And it's a lot of uncertainty because of the future of LeBron James. And with that being said, if you know that LeBron James is possibly going to leave next summer, and if you're Kyrie Irving, right now you have all the leverage. You want to be in a situation in which you can kind of control your future and control your destiny. And that's what he's trying to do. He's trying to take matters into his own hand right now and use his talent while he can and try to, you know, navigate himself to a good situation.
The part of this report that stood out to me, Karan, was the explicit reference that was made that Kyrie said he no longer wanted to play with LeBron James. If that part is true, does it make it impossible for Kyrie to come back into that locker room next season?
I don't think it makes it impossible because it depends on, you know, what was actually said. And let's just face it. I mean, obviously every player that's a Robin wants to be a Batman. They want to be a Batman on every team. And I don't know, like, the facts of this. This all speculation. But, look, you know, to play alongside LeBron James, listen, if you're winning, you're going to Eastern Conference Finals, you're winning, going to the NBA Finals consecutive years, and you probably want to be in a position where you're the leader, you're the Batman, and you're the guy that's leading teams. And trust me, it's not going to be as easy without a guy like LeBron James. But if that's a challenge that you're up for, obviously you got a championship under your belt. You're considered one of the best superstars in this game, and you want to take on that next challenge. Just understand the pros and the cons of what you wanted to accept. And it's going to be much different without playing with LeBron James.
Do you think that LeBron James is difficult to play with?
I think he's one of the most unselfish superstars I've ever seen in the game of basketball. And, you know, and with that being said, you know, one of the best all-around basketball players I've seen in my lifetime, you know, from a scoring, passing, rebound, you name it, he do it. And, you know, still being durable and being available, you know, I think his biggest strength is always being available. He lacks to have injuries and things like that. And, you know, going forward, he shows no signs of slowing down. So that window for being successful for the Cleveland Cavaliers is still going to be extremely successful, you know. And, you know, you're looking at the Eastern Conference, you have two contenders out there in Washington and Boston, and some would say the Toronto Raptors. But after that, you know, Cleveland is still, you know, reigning superior in the Eastern Conference. So you don't want to break up a good thing, you know, and I hate to see this happen if the speculation is true.
Yeah, one of the things I wonder, Karan, and we're talking to Karan Butler, former NBA forward, joining me here at Dan Patrick Show. One of the things that I wonder is that if a couple of years from now, Kyrie Irving regrets doing what he's trying to do, because we've seen in the past star players force their way out of situations and then, you know, publicly have some regrets. I mean, I alluded to Stephon Marbury, what he did in Minnesota with Kevin Garnett. We all know with Shaq and Kobe, what they have said about, you know, doing things a little bit differently. If I had to make a prediction, I would think that a few years from now, if Kyrie Irving is a Phoenix Sun or a member of the Orlando Magic, that he looks back on all this and maybe has some regrets.
Man, it's a lot of specials out there, 30 for 30 specials, you know, Shaq and Penny. You look at situations on what could have been, you know, T-Mac and Grant Hill possibly, and Vince Carter and T-Mac and Shaq and Kobe. And, you know, the list goes on with these dynamic duos and pairs and, you know, Russell Westbrook and KD and what could have happened or what would have happened. But, you know, it's all about, you know, what's making you happy. Look, this window opportunity for you to be on this platform is only so long. And, you know, I make reference to some of those greats because, you know, that's our timeline. That's our basketball history. And when you're in the moment of your career, it's always things that you can, you know, kind of go back to the history of the game and resonate with. And that's what, you know, some of the guys need to do. You know, do your research and see the cause and effect of, you know, what can happen. And, you know, for the majority of those guys that went through those situations, they had a lot of positive things that come out of it and a lot of negative. You know, you look at Shaq when he went to Miami, he still won a championship. But, you know, imagine what the dominance could have been with him and Kobe for years.
Yeah.
You know, they could have continued to have success. So, you know, it's just things to look at. And obviously they both said they was regretful for some things. So hopefully that's set in and hopefully those guys can make amends. But, you know, wow, it's going to be interesting to see what happened with Kyrie going forward.
You played for a lot of organizations in your career, Karan, some good, some not so good. As a player, how aware are you of, you know, front office turmoil and or things that are happening? I asked this in reference to what's going on in Cleveland with David Griffin being let go, Kobe Altman, a relative unknown, being elevated. It doesn't seem like the most stable situation. How aware are players about what's going on above them?
I mean, back in the past, you know, it was really more a secretive thing. But now, because of social media and because, you know, relationships and contacts, you know, things are more in the forefront. So there's no more secrets out there. You know, you kind of get information is something that you have access to, all information. So where there's smoke, there's fire. And obviously, it's things that you can't cover up. Once it gets legs, it runs. And right now, you know, it's running a full marathon. So guys know what the pulse of the organization is in Cleveland, you know, inside out. And the superstar guys know that, you know, going forward, you know, they got to protect their legacy. They got to protect their vans, their brands. And, you know, guys are looking at it from a long-term point of view. And they learn it from guys that didn't look at it like that. So, you know, I understand that. And the future of, you know, Kyrie is definitely in question because of it.
I would think as a young player, and Kyrie's only 25 years old, seems like he's been around forever, but he's only 25. I would think as a young player that the general manager and the owner is just as important as the head coach, because these are the guys that you're trusting your future to. It's why I think guys like Oklahoma City, because Sam Presti is there. It's why guys like San Antonio, because R.C. Buford and Greg Popovich have a terrific track record of success. I would think for a young player that, you know, it's equally as important to have a top-shelf front office as it is to have a great coach.
Absolutely. And, you know, you want to have stability. And, you know, once the firing happened of the GM, you know, that was a huge blow. That was devastating. Obviously, that was something that LeBron and those guys, you know, wasn't in complete approval of. And then you look at that situation, and then now you look at the situation going forward where, you know, you heard rumblings where LeBron wasn't really happy with the acquisitions that, you know, they made so far this summer, you know, with guys like Jamal Crawford out there and free agencies and stuff like that. You know, and not adding them to the team to kind of bulk their roster up, because, you know, the Golden State Warriors are going to be there. They're going to be there for the next 2 or 3 years. And, you know, it need to be teams out there to compete with them. And if you go as assembled as you did last year, you're not going to be successful. So you're looking at, you know, the progress of the team. And then once you're stagnant, you know, you have to question, is this the place for me to be? And I think Kyrie is doing that. And I think LeBron is questioning that as well.
Always great to visit with you, Karan. Terrific stuff. I appreciate the time.
Thanks, bro.
That's Karan Butler, the former NBA forward, joining me here on The Dan Patrick Show.
The Dan Patrick Show, weekday mornings on Audience.